WWE star pays tribute to Jay Briscoe following WrestleMania, and Chris Jericho responds to CM Punk. But first, we have an injury update on the absent Matt Jackson, who makes up one half of the Young Bucks. The AEW star would partially tear his bicep on the March 15th episode of Dynamite, this during the trios match against the Jericho Appreciation Society and the champions, the House of Black. Taking to Wrestling Observer Radio this week, Dave Meltzer would reveal the expected timeline for Matt's return and said, "He's getting therapy, of course, for the injury, a partially torn bicep. Hopeful for double or nothing, the timetable he was given was 6 to 8 weeks, and that is enough time for double or nothing, but that's not a guarantee, but it's certainly a strong hope." And we're in the midst of WrestleMania weekend with the undisputed WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns set to defend his title against Royal Rumble winner Cody Rhodes in the main event of tonight's Night 2 show. For the past year, however, there has been much talk of Roman's cousin The Rock making his return to WWE, setting up a match to find out who's the true head of the table of the Anoa'i family, something the company have been pushing to make happen. For one reason or another, this would not come to be, at least this year, although the tribal chief would speak with ESPN this week about the possibility of eventually taking on the Great One at some point in the future, and Reigns would say, "I think anybody would love to have that match. They'd be lying if they said they didn't. I could tribal chief you and say blah blah, but at the end of the day, I want what's going to be biggest for the fans, because that's going to reflect what I was able to accomplish. If that's one of the biggest ones out there, let's do it. But if not, like everything else in life, we're going to roll with the punches." One of the big stories coming out of WrestleMania weekend so far has been the incident involving Impact Knockout Giselle Shaw and tag team legend Rick Steiner. At the recent WrestleCon event, Steiner allegedly hurled abuse at Shaw, with him taking issue with the fact that she's transgender. Well, we now have an update on how the issue was dealt with by WrestleCon organizers, with it being reported by PW Insider that Steiner was not allowed back in the facility, and the report notes, PW Insider was told that Rick Steiner had left the event to attend last night's WWE Hall of Fame ceremony. WrestleCon did not have the ability to speak with Steiner until this morning. We are told that Steiner was informed he was not allowed to enter or take part in the remainder of WrestleCon's events. Steiner was not booked by the convention itself, but was booked by a third-party vendor who had purchased table space at the event. WrestleCon is attempting to facilitate the two parties speaking about the incident, but thus far, that has not happened. Now let's get onto the event of WrestleMania itself, as night one of the show would take place last night in Hollywood, California. The opening match would pit the returning John Cena against the WWE United States Champion Austin Theory, with the title on the line. Although Cena would make Theory tap out to an STF, the referee wasn't there to make the call, and this would open the opportunity up for Theory to drop his idol with an A-Town Down for the 1-2-3 in what felt like a passing of the torch moment. And before we continue, why not drop a like down below if you're enjoying the video, and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest wrestling news as we try to reach 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. But with that said, let's get to the next story. Later in the show, Seth Rollins would find himself across the ring from social media influencer Logan Paul in what turned out to be another impressive performance for the rookie. Logan wasn't the only online megastar present, however, as it was revealed that popular UK star KSI was hiding under the Prime mascot costume, with him at least attempting to aid his business partner to victory. However, things didn't go to plan, as Rollins would pull KSI onto the announce table just as Logan was about to leap onto him, leading to JJ being wiped out in the process. Rollins would then go on to score the win with a curb stomp heard around the world. An appearance from KSI, who is known for his role in The Sidemen, as well as being a YouTuber, boxer, and musician, would lead to talk of if this is the first of many appearances in WWE, something he was asked about after the show. JJ would note that he's up for the challenge before naming a potential opponent, and he would say, "You never know, you never know. If I was to choose an opponent, I don't even know. Bobby Lashley put me in with the Beast. He's like triple the size of me. I'm up for the challenge, YOLO." The show would see yet another celebrity get involved in the finish of a match later in the night, this at the end of the father versus son match between Rey and Dominic Mysterio. As Dom attempted to use a chain planted by Judgment Day teammate Damian Priest, it was music star Bad Bunny that got involved, who was on commentary for the match, with him preventing him, which allowed Rey to set up the 619 for the 1-2-3. Night 1 of WrestleMania would also see two title changes throughout the show. The first, when we would see Charlotte Flair defend her SmackDown Women's Championship against Royal Rumble winner Rhea Ripley, a match that made history despite not main eventing the show. This was the first time that there was an all-female cast on a WrestleMania card, with ring announcer Samantha Irvin, referee Jessica Carr, and of course Rhea and Charlotte in the ring. Ripley would walk away as the new champion after an avalanche riptide from the top rope was enough to put the former champion away, putting a bow on her tremendous rise over the course of the last year. And the main event of the show would see the undisputed tag team championships on the line, the first time a tag title match has main evented WWE's biggest show. The match would see Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn battle undisputed champs the Usos for the belts in what may be the fall of the first domino of the bloodline. It was Sami and Kevin that left the SoFi Stadium with the titles after Zayn put Jey Uso to sleep with three haluva kicks for the pinfall win in what felt like a true feel-good moment. After the show, Kevin and Sami would appear in front of the media as part of the press conference, where the Bloodline story was discussed. Zayn would reveal that he feels that the slow burn, emotion-based storyline could change the way wrestling is presented going forward, and would say, "One of the things that I take a lot of pride in with this story over the past year is that I do think it transcended the classic kind of wrestling storyline for sure. I actually think because of its effectiveness, I think it could be a glimpse of what storylines going forward, if not achieve, will at least aspire to, in my opinion. But much like you saw with television, how it kind of evolved to the golden age of television in the 2000s with HBO and things like that, and more complex and layered characters, so to do this story, if I may be so bold as to offer for a comparison, it's almost like The Sopranos. It is to WWE what The Sopranos was to television, if I may be so bold as to make that comparison." Kevin Owens would then pay tribute to those that helped the two men get to this point, including Jey and Mark Briscoe, with him noting, "Before I go, two things. The Usos, even though everybody loves them, everybody appreciates them. They're underappreciated. They're the best. Unbelievable. I don't have enough good words for them. And also, I said PWG helped get us here. Super Dragon helped us get here. There's two other guys that really helped us get here. Their names are Mark and Jey Briscoe. We lost Jey recently. I really hope we made him proud tonight because, God, great guy. We really miss him." Chris Jericho would find himself on the receiving end of a name drop from former AEW World Champion CM Punk last week, with the straight edge superstar taking to his Instagram story to call Y2J a liar and a stooge, suggesting that it was he that leaked certain stories about him to the media. Appearing on the Mark Madden show this week, Jericho would give his feelings on a potential CM Punk AEW return in the aftermath of the Instagram post, noting that you don't need to get along to coexist. And when asked if he was on CM Punk's Christmas card list, Jericho would respond, "You know, I'm not, but I wasn't on Scott Hall's Christmas card list, or I wasn't on, you know, Eric Bischoff's Christmas card list. You don't have to be best friends to coexist, so to me, that's not really my wheelhouse. I'm not in charge of that. I'm sure there will be some answers to that pretty quickly, I would assume. AEW's gonna thrive and survive with or without him, so I guess we'll just have to wait and see what happens." And before you go, make sure you check out the 10 free agents that are set to shake up WrestleMania season.